We'll be right back. Du bruit pour Marco. Ok, merci à tous, vous étiez super super chaud. Alors, le son ne s'arrête pas. Je vous propose deux choses, vous avez le choix. Soit vous venez nous voir, on va interviewer Marcoul là en haut, vous nous suivez. Enfin, pour s'il y a de la place. Ceux qui veulent écouter l'interview de Marcoul, et sinon le son reprend. Et c'est Thurman qui reprend les platines. Un maximum de bruit pour Thurman. Et on passe à l'interview de Marcoul. Dans 10 secondes, restez en ligne. Bien. Alors, voilà. Comment ? Bon, de toute façon... Wow, attention. Bon, on va attendre Marcoul, là, qui est entouré de fans, donc il met du temps un petit peu à arriver. Merci à tous, en tout cas, de nous avoir suivis aussi nombreux. Thank you very much, everyone. We'll do the interview in English, because Marcoul is Canadian. And here it is. Marcoul, make some noise for Marcoul. Okay, so if you have questions to ask to Marcoul, you have a few minutes to think about it.
I have a question.
Oh, you have a question for me? Yeah.
How was the really pee that you just did right now?
How was the what?
The pee that you just did.
I just did.
Am I asking questions to myself or to you?
Oh, no, no. I ask you questions.
Okay,
so maybe there will be some online question. If you have question, you can ask to Marcoul. First of all, how are you, Marcoul?
Really hot,
right?
It was crazy down there.
Yeah.
And
how did you feel? How did you feel the audience in Paris tonight?
I was scared because I thought if I play some weird stuff, maybe they're going to be like, oh, no, we don't like weird. But they liked it. They like weird stuff.
So. They really liked it, yeah.
So that made me more comfortable. I'm like, oh, okay, now it's a party.
Yeah.
And so party.
A party on Monday, you know?
Party on Monday.
Yeah.
I want a shirt that says party on Monday.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
I have a lot of questions. You start beginning the music industry, the electronic music industry. A few years ago, like 20 years ago, I guess.
I'm old, yeah.
Yeah. What was your setup when you first began? And now, what is your setup? Can you describe it, like the evolution?
Wow. There's been like 20 evolutions. Can you tilt the speaker?
Yeah, maybe.
Tourner le haut-parleur.
Ouais, peut-être tourner le haut-parleur un petit peu. But I think it's the music down there.
No. Alors, so when I first started, it was Richie Houghton, and he goes, Mark, I want you to come play in Berlin.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And
est-ce que vous pouvez tourner?
Okay, it's
okay.
It's fine.
Can you speak really?
Yes. So,
yeah.
When I first met Richie, he's like, Mark, I want you to play in Berlin. And I'm like, well, how do I play? Like, I don't understand.
So, Richie Houghton, right?
He told me I have to play. He's like, you have to play in Berlin. But I never knew how to play. Like, I was a studio nerd.
Yeah.
And so he said, here's this new program called Ableton. Take it. And he gave me a controller, like this old, an old like MS-20. And he's like, take this, do this, do this, do this. I'm like, ah, okay. And that was my first live for like, and it lasted for like 20 years. From
so Richie Ottin told, like,
yeah, he knows everything. Like, he's a crazy guy. Yeah. He knows everything. So like, Mark, you should do this. You're like, okay. Because he knows, like, he's been there before.
Yeah. And in 2015, you were in Richie Ottin's label until 2015. Why did you choose to start your own label, which is called Item and Things?
Well, my girlfriend told me I should leave.
Oh, yeah, really?
Like, the reality is my girlfriend said I should leave and start my own thing. So I did. And I don't know. I think I would have been happier staying. Because the music business is lots of commercialism, lots of like marketing, and you have to be like a businessman.
Yeah.
And I'm not a businessman. I'm like a nerd, DJ, music guy. So for me to leave and start my own label was stupid. Like, yeah, I should have just stayed with Minus. Like, stay with the marketing genius, Richie.
Yeah.
But I didn't.
And speaking about nerd, is it true that you first began like putting video game sounds in your tracks?
Oh yeah, like
it inspired you?
No, like when I was little, every day I played video games, Commodore 64, Atari. So when I hear the sounds, it reminds me of happy playing games, like woo. So. I mean, even now, like, if I have a song, I'm like, oh, what sound should I put? I'll, like, look up some, like, Zelda samples or something. Like, oh, okay, here we go. Yeah.
Okay. I will check if someone has... yeah, tell me.
I'm speaking really loud, I feel like...
No, that's fine. Don't worry. I think people hear you in the audience.
Put some filters so I sound normal.
But I'm really sorry because here we can't really hear you.
I know, people
cannot hear you.
Hey, it's techno.
But online people can hear
techno,
you.
It's techno.
So people are asking when you are coming to play in London.
When they give me money to play in London.
So you can follow him on his page and he will... Yeah. So Jimmy is asking... Ask his next for his next album. So, in last year, like this year in April, you released your album Sinister Mind.
Sinister Mind. Yeah.
Yeah. And so Jimmy is asking when is the second one, because I think it's a trilogy, right?
Yeah. Okay. So I was really stupid. So at the beginning of the year, I made a whole bunch of songs, like 50 songs, and I'm like, wow, these are great. There's like three albums here, like, wow, like different, one style might be like dark, one style might be techno, another style might be like synthy. There's three albums here. Okay, everyone, I'm releasing three albums. And then afterwards, I'm like, you know what, this techno album sucks. I'm like, I can do better, I can do better, I can do better, I can do better. So now I'm at the point where, like, you know, it's like September, October, and I gotta like really do better really fast, so.
So you're taking your time, right?
But I have to release it before the end of the year. I have to, like, to follow my word.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I think...
Never promise anything.
Yeah.
Because
you're
later,
right.
Because later, like a song that you think is great, like, oh, this song's so good.
Yeah.
And then like a month later you listen to it and you're like, oh, boo.
Right. And so Jimmy, you have your answer. Yeah, everyone was sweating. Yeah, right. It's really hot here.
Fucking hot, man.
Yeah, fucking hot. So what advice can Mark tell to the new generation of producer? Question from NTOs. It's difficult, right?
Well, I don't know. Like, when I first started making music, it wasn't to get signed. It was just for fun. Like, oh, I like making music. So for 20 years, I just made songs in my studio for myself. And then later, like, Richie Hutton heard them. I'm like, hey, what is this stuff? I'm like, I don't know. Some stuff I made. He's like, okay, come. I'm like, okay. But a lot of producers produce so they can get famous. And some producers produce because they have to. And I think if you just stay at home, make a million songs, like 1,000 songs, you develop a style, you develop a personality. And if someone hears one of your songs, they go, oh, this is one of your songs. Yeah. And that's more important than anything else, because there's so much shit out there, like no style, no personality. And if you can have something that's like your, like it sounds like you, boom, that's it. Make 1,000 more songs and it's finished.
So produce, work a lot.
Develop a style, yeah.
So you have your answer, and Theo's, when you come to Chile, it's amazing. When you come back to Ecuador.
South America, right?
Yeah, South America. Why do you play vocals live instead of recording them before? Question from Jose Antonio.
Because if I record them before and I just play them, people think I'm a DJ.
Yeah.
If I do them live on stage, people go, oh, he's got a microphone. Oh, he's singing that. Ah, maybe he made this song.
It's real live.
Yeah, it's real live. So I don't like doing it. I prefer just playing like a recording, but I mean, people need to know, like, there's producers like live, so that's why I do it.
And speaking about not DJing, so why did you choose not to DJ?
Because I don't know anything about music. Like, no, really. Like, like people go, oh, do you know that new album by blah blah? I'll go like, no.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
I'm not a DJ.
What are your biggest idols right now?
Oh shit, our likes are going down.
Yeah, it's maybe some people are not understanding because we are speaking English, and maybe I'm speaking with too much bad accent, you know. So what are your biggest idols?
I have no idols.
You have no idols?
No. My dog, my keyboards. Like really, it's like my life. In the morning, I wake up, I have coffee, I take my dog out to pee, then I play music with my keyboards, then I take my dog out to play ball, then I play more music with keyboards, and that's my life, like that's all I do.
So maybe she will play with you sometime.
Yeah.
Right? A B2B like kind of.
Yeah.
Okay, I will just ask a last question and then...
I think one good question should be, hey Mark, why don't you give your music to like some hot girl who could just go on stage and play her music and pretend it's hers and she'll make lots of money because everyone likes hot girls on stage, and why don't you do that?
I think there were some hot girls on the stage, right?
No, but I mean, if the hot girl was pretending it was her music.
Oh, yeah, right.
Anyway, I'm planning on it. That's my next move.
So one last question. Where he does get inspiration? Oh, I think... Where do you get inspiration? Oh, and there is another question. Maybe you will be...
Savez-vous planter le chou? À la mode, savez-vous planter le chou? À la mode de chez nous. On les plante avec les coudes. À la mode... Most of my inspiration comes from when I was little, like Sesame Street, French songs. C'est la vie donc qui nous mène, un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, bicyclette, violette. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, six, sept, violette.
Yeah. I see. Okay, so that's all your inspiration, right?
They're all stuck in my head. It's like
So we have a little tradition.
I'm sorry,
it's a little gift.
Uh-oh.
So it's a little gift we offer to the producers we invite. And here is some gift for you. I let you discover. It's called the mystery box.
Is it an animal?
The mystery box.
Animal?
Hello!
I think you like great wine.
And Bordeaux. 2010
Margaux, it's really a great wine.
Mieux en 2005, mais j'aime aussi le 2010.
2005, yeah. So it's typically French. And also a souvenir of here. A little t-shirt. Thank you very much, Mark.
Thank you.
And Thank you very much. You
Et bonne soirée. Maintenant, je vais faire un party. I'm going to party now.
Yeah, you're going to party now. Yeah. Thank you very much, Mark.
Cheers. Thank you, man.
Merci beaucoup à tous. Thank you very much online. You were a lot of people online. And I wanted also to thank... Oh, it's really difficult. It's really difficult. It's really difficult to speak because music is really loud. But thank you to all of our partners and thank you to Salon Hoche, which is the amazing venue that has accepted us tonight. So thank you very much and see you next Monday. Bye-bye.